Hello, Twitchiverse. My name is K-Ball. Welcome to Game 15 of the Madness Greatest All-Time Tournament, Round 1. Today we got the 22-seed Texans and the 11-seed Saints. Without further ado, let's watch the game. I'll see you guys at the end.
In today's matchup, we've got a pair of running backs who are hoping for plenty of touches to come their way. It's Miller's Texans going up against Peterson's Saints. For the call, let's send you out to the broadcast booth, where we'll join our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, thank you. We are down on the bayou as you get a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in New Orleans. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Houston Texans. Hi again, everyone. I'm Brandon Godden. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And, Charles, we look at a matchup like this. It's really the running backs that may take center stage here today.
And in today's football, they're still valuable, not just as runners, but guys who can catch the ball as well. It's really the number of touches that determines things these days.
Here's the kicker, Nick Novak, to get us started. And we are underway from the Superdome. This fielded at the 2. Dances by him. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And here come the Saints for their opening drive. Leading him out, one of the all-time greats. Hard to believe in his 17th season now, Drew Brees.
His numbers sometimes are just absolutely staggering because last year threw for the 4th highest total in NFL history, 5,208 yards. Okay, now if you look in the record books, here's the number that he occupies in single season passing. 2nd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 8th, and 11th best single seasons in NFL history. That's crazy.
Yeah, you said staggering when you started talking, and I'm going to finish it with staggering. What a career it's been, and it continues for Mr. Brees. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
Shotgun now for Brees. It's brought in here by Willie Snead. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 16 yards on the game's first play and a quick first down.
But that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Now Brees. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And that'll bring up 2nd down. Let's get a quick look at the Saints offense.
Quarterback Drew Brees and head coach Sean Payton understand the passing game as well as anyone in the NFL, which led to a rating last year of number one in passing and number one in total overall offense. But the thing that they really do well is get the ball downfield. They understand holes in defenses, find receivers that way. But what they need to add, the running game, back to their mix. When they went to the Super Bowl and won it, they were number 6 in the NFL. Last season, number 16.
Brees will try again on 2nd down. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Striders defensively for Houston, and kind of want to make this about J.J. Watt, Charles, and what he's done for the victims of Hurricane Harvey. He matched the donations up to $100,000, and as soon as he set up the website for donations, it soared past $100,000, so really neat to see what he's done there.
And continues to use his face, his voice, his presence. I think he's social media to send the word out to try and donate, help, do what you can for those victims of Hurricane Harvey. J.J. Watt, plenty of empathy for the people there in the Houston area.
And we send the Madden family thoughts to those people in the Houston area as well. Breeze gonna throw. The catch made over the middle by Ginn. 20, 10, touchdown, New Orleans. Ted Ginn. Saints have taken the early lead. Coming into the year, Breeze, 465 touchdown passes, add another one to the total.
You know, it's funny, I just talked with his college head coach, and he told me that when Drew was a sophomore at Purdue, they weren't sure he was truly the starter, even though he started the opening game, and he made a play early in that one. But the coach got on the headset and told the rest of the staff, well, fellas, we found our quarterback. Now we got to make sure we find the rest of our team.
Breeze hasn't looked back since. Will Lutz on for the point after. Good as the Saints have a 7-0 lead. A drive there of just 4 plays, and it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. Instead, the punter out to kick it off. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Tom Savage marching onto the field, a 27-year-old QB who will be the starting QB, according to head coach Bill O'Brien. He said that on August 22nd. Now, of course, you've got Deshaun Watson lurking in the shadows.
And that began on draft night, didn't it?
It did.
Houston Texans moved up, selected Deshaun Watson. So the clock is ticking. Eventually, he will be the starting quarterback. But Tom Savage has earned this job. He's earned the trust of his head coach. And DeAndre Hopkins, their top receiver, says that, yes, Tom Savage should be the number one signal caller.
Now a first carry for Lamar Miller. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. And let's take a look at the Texans' offense.
When you think of the Texans, you think this is a team that likes to throw the football. In 2016, though, they weren't very good at it. 29th overall in passing, but they were 8th in rushing. So let's see if they lean on the running game to start this contest. And they're hoping to get more consistency throwing the ball downfield.
There's Savage now on second. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Haole Kikaha. Coming hard on the blitz, he dumps him for a loss of 8.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack. So after the sack of Savage, the Texans with a 3rd and long forthcoming.
All right, here we go. Boom,
from the gun, here's Savage. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. Last year, New Orleans deaths, something that was exploited game after game. You know, though, those guys are tired of hearing about it. Now they just want to fix it.
And you fix it with players playing better. We know that. But also you fix it with scheme. You look at what you have and say, can we play the style that we played in 2016? And you and I both know the New Orleans defensive staff. They like to be aggressive. They like to get after the quarterback, put their guys in a lot of man coverage. Maybe we'll play a little more zone in 2017, take some of the pressure off of the back end of the defense.
A first down carry now for Miller. Oh, a nice spin. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. On the defensive side of the ball for New Orleans, here's the starting lineup. And it's a defense that you say should be improved this year. I know it's preseason, but first 3 weeks, they've only given up 27 points.
And they made some moves to increase their presence on defense. Manti Te'o has come over as a linebacker. A.J. Klein as well. But drafted Marshawn Lattimore in the first round. That was big for them at the corner position. Had a couple pass breakups in their last game. Almost had an interception. They shut out the Houston Texans. The New Orleans Saints? That's the best evidence that they can give of being much improved.
And now the fans hoping that that carries over to the regular season. Caught left side, Hopkins. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
The Saints with an extra defensive back here on third on the field.
Could they blitz?
Out of the gun, Savage. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Here now, Shane Leckler, 41-year-old punter, to kick it away. Back deep for the Saints is Ted Ginn. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. The Saints get set to trot out there. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say, when you run in the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
He was trying to hit Thomas that time, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Breeze again here on second and 10. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Breeze to another longtime vet, Ginn, for the New Orleans first.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Now the first carry for Adrian Peterson. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You may also just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down.
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
On second down, here's Breeze. Caught by Snead over the middle. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. And the Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Over the middle, it's Thomas. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Breeze on the hook up to Thomas for the New Orleans first. Saints were the best team in the NFL on third down last year. 49% conversion rate helps when you have Drew Brees back there.
It certainly does because he is just so analytical in everything he does. Goes through every progression on every snap in practice, so not much surprises him on game day.
Down, here's a run with Peterson. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And he had a nice play there from his free safety position to hold him to nothing.
And Brandon, remember when the free safety was always back away from the line of scrimmage?
That's changed.
But, oh, is that changed in a big way? The way we see it now, they're almost mirrors between the free safety and the strong safety. One will be up, one will be back, or sometimes both will be in the same spot. On that play, the free safety was there, no gain.
And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
Awfully nice to see Adrian Peterson back and running well. Look, it was just 2015 when he won his last rushing title. Got hurt in 2016, and that season became a bit of a wash.
Yeah, it did become. Hoping to get back to that old form that you're alluding to, though. He does have three rushing titles, including that one you mentioned in 2015. The Saints put up 29 points a game last year, second only to the Falcons, and they're in range to get some points on this drive as well. First and 10. From the gun, it's Breeze. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Jadeveon Clowney. Coming in from that outside linebacker spot, he gets him down for a loss of 5. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Second down, Peterson. And he'll work his way inside the 30 now to the 28. Able to pick up a healthy chunk of yards, 7-yard gain, but a tough 3rd and 9 upcoming. Getting the sense, Charles, are going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. Now Breeze. He finds Coleman. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. So a big third down hookup here will take us to the break. 7-0 is our score. We'll head back to New Orleans after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Saints football to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. And the seemingly endless drive continues. Peterson alone in the backfield. And he'll get it up the middle. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And they give him five that time as they draw a bit closer here for a second and goal. They're mounting a nice drive here. Good chunk of yardage there again. O-line, they've been solid this drive.
They have that look about them right now that says, if you do anything but run the ball behind us, you're crazy. They have really moved it well on this drive, and they want to finish it off the same way.
They'll run for it with Peterson. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Adrian Peterson. Taking it in, and the Saints add on to their lead. And there you go, nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking, beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
And it's good to make it 14-0. So that drive, 12 plays in length, and it's capped off by a touchdown run by Adrian Peterson. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. Akeem Hunt now to return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Texans offense as they get set to take over here. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
Now it's Savage off the bootleg. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Will Fuller was the intended target, and it's third and short. So just 1 yard to go here on third down. They'll try to run for it with Miller. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. He needed a yard. That's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
On first. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
To throw on second down is Savage. His throw here is incomplete. Alfred Blue, the man he was looking for. And it's third down. Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now. Savage from the shotgun snap. He finds his target, Fuller. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down. Savage on first down. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Normally when I talk about DeAndre Hopkins, I'm talking about accomplishments. In this case, I'm remembering that he lost nearly 600 yards in receiving from 2015. He had less than 1,000 last year.
Yeah, and his touchdowns dropped from 11 to 4, so now he's hoping for more consistent quarterback play. Miller. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
No gain on that run. And while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I've got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit and throwing it a little bit more.
They'll run it again with Miller. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll, in fact, tackle him behind the line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
The Texans on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 11. Off of play action. Savage. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down.
I think the training and practice broke down on that play because he simply didn't run the route deep enough to get to the first down marker, despite what was a really nice catch and toe tap on the sideline.
Well, that's third down 101. You got to go to the marker, know where it is. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took them a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
It's Nick Novak back out following his field goal to send it away. On the return, it's Ted Ginn Jr. And some room to roam now. Ted Ginn's gonna go. The 20, 10, touchdown, New Orleans. Ted Ginn, 97 yards. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. Special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with, and they say challenge him, kick it to him. The way he runs, as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there. Lotso look to add the extra point. And it's 21-3. And quite a bit of razzle-dazzle and electricity on that return. It goes for 97 yards. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. This fielded at the 2. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back on the field here. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder, puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. And 10, Savage. It's complete. It's Miller. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. A gain of 6 there on first.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone or...
Better against man because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Second down, here's Miller. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down.
There hasn't been much to crow about when we talk about defenders in New Orleans in recent years. But Cameron Jordan certainly is a guy that we should respect.
Is he what they will kind of build around on that line?
Yeah, they have to, because not only is he a good player out on the edge, he can work inside a little bit as well. But it's his leadership and his passion for the game that they'll really utilize.
And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. Coming up at halftime, remember, we'll get you out to Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of this first half. That is, of course, unless you decide to skip him.
And for the record, we do not encourage that.
Here's Shane Leckler now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. Adrian Peterson now getting ready to go again on offense. So a 6-carry drive the last go-around, touchdown on the end of it. We'll see if they can duplicate that here.
I think that they would like to. I know every runner that we've ever met would love to carry the ball more and more and more. In fact, we keep a ball in the booth just for demonstration purposes.
You're holding it right now.
I'm going to give it to you. Is it heavy? Is it that heavy?
No, it's pretty light.
It's pretty light, right? So keep giving it to him and let him do his work. It's not going to slow him down.
If it's light for me, it's definitely light for him. On first and 10, here's Breeze. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. When you and I did the weekly commentary updates last year, it seemed like we always used to talk about Michael Thomas week after week.
And it piled up. 92 catches on the season, but the thing that really struck me was doing a New Orleans game and talking with a few of his teammates who talked about how much the game meant to him. And he was upset with guys he didn't think cared about the game enough. Unusual for a rookie, but it's a good sign for him.
Down, Breeze brought in left side by Sneed, and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does. And the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Breeze now on first down. Throwing the slant pattern here, complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Down is Breeze. It's complete. Fleener, right side. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Kobe Fleener, 29 yards. And the Saints add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Now they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Wants to try to add the PAT. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. Just a four-play drive that time. And it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This will be taken in at the one. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And a look now at Lamar Miller. He's had a good chunk of carries. Problem is, for very little success. I don't want to put it all on his shoulders, but that's a big reason they're losing right now.
Have to be very careful that he doesn't start pointing fingers. Offensive line obviously trying. The defense has done a nice job against him today. When it's all said and done, it's all about the guy in the mirror. He has to get it done better going forward.
See if he can look and do some soul searching now. Down throw coming. Savage. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. They were trying to get the connection with a former Buckeye, Braxton Miller. That'll bring up second down.
You know, every time we talk with people about the most important quality for a quarterback to have in the NFL, what do they usually cite?
Arm strength.
Yeah, and that's really way down on the list. Accuracy is one of the bigger ones, maybe the foremost one. That's what he needed on that play.
And back to the air. Savage on second down. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Hopkins. And a stoppage here. A timeout before this third down play takes place. As the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. The Texans on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This will be third and five. Operating from the gun, Savage. Over the middle, complete. It's Hunt. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. And now a first down following that long gain.
All right, here we go. Green, 39. Green, hot.
Throwing again is Savage. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hopkins. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. DeAndre Hopkins, as the first half is winding down, and the Texans cut into that lead.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps, but they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in the second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. Nick Novak on now for the extra point. And this is up and good. It cuts the lead to 28-10 now. So that drive, four plays, and it results in the Texans finding the end zone. Novak out now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The drive with Peterson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that would look pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard attempt. And this one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good. So it's halftime here in New Orleans with the Saints out in front. As we send you on over to Orlando, where we'll check in with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon. And welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Saints are happy to be sitting in the locker room with the lead. The Texans didn't play their best, and they'll need to be at their best now to come back. All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Saints opening drive. Here's Drew Brees targeting the speedy Ted Ginn, and that goes as a 50-yard touchdown as they get out to a 7-0 lead. He goes to the second. Peterson's looking for room to run, and he capped off the long drive with a touchdown as they move out in front 14-0. Novak's got to boot it away. Ginn's the one on the return, and he'll take this all the way for a touchdown. Saints go up by 18. First and 10, Brees is going to complete the pass, and a quick three-play drive ends with a score. That takes the lead up to 25. Now first and 10, Hopkins wide open, able to make the grab. And this four-play drive goes for a touchdown, closing the gap to 18.
All right, Larry, indeed a one-sided affair to this point as we get set for half two. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This fielded at the two. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And the Texans set to come onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Second half begins with a run from Miller. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
No gain on that run. And while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Again, it's Miller. And he'll get about three as he takes this up near the 25. Not the start to the drive they were hoping for. That run doesn't get him much at all.
No, not at all. And that leaves him with third and long, which means you've got to dial up something pretty good. Think your best player with a play that he likes to run best.
The Texans on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This is third and eight. From the gun, here's Savage. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. Just a one-yard pickup on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. Here's Shane Leckler now as he's on to punt for Houston. Here's Ginn. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Down. And he's got it over the middle. Fleener. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Wide open receiver complete, and he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. He got 29 yards that time.
For many teams, the evaluation of tight ends has really changed. We used to wonder about how they would block first and foremost. Now we want to know how these guys can run because we envision them in offenses, catch the ball. How much yardage can they gain after that?
And that on display there for a good pickup. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Peter Anderson gets the handoff from Breeze. Pretty nice aggressive run there before being brought down just inside of the 30. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
See if they stay on the ground for second down. They'll fake to Peterson, and now Breeze. And he is out of bounds, but not before taking this down to the 8. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. The offense operating inside the 10 at the 8 here. It's first and goal. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Working with a second and goal now from the 3. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4 down territory.
This offense so far on third down, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and goal. Shotgun now for Breeze. And he's got his man, that's Snead. Touchdown, New Orleans. Willie Snead from 4 yards out. And the Saints now at 6 to their lead. An out route there for the score, a quick route there for the score.
Yeah, you're not really surveying the defense on this one. You're just counting on timing, making this play happen. 1-2, ball's out of his hands, knows where he's going, just puts it to the outside. Touchdown.
Lutzel looked to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This is fielded at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now out comes Houston. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
And he's got him over the middle. Fedorowicz. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Savage, his throw incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd and 5. The Texans on 3rd down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be 3rd and 5. Savage now to throw, but he finds his man Griffin. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on 3rd.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play? Made a nice catch and picked up a 1st down.
That's what impresses me about him. When he's called upon, usually gets it done. So here we go, 1st and 10 now. To the air again, Savage. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. So the incomplete pass brings up 2nd down.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
They go play action with Miller. Now it's Savage. Going deep for Hopkins. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their 1st. And it's 3rd down now.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
The Texans on 3rd down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is 3rd and 10. Savage wants to throw yet again. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
Holding offense.
So instead of giving them another 3rd down, they'll decline it, brings up 4.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
Here's Shane Leckler now as he's on to punt for Houston. And that is very well done there, as this will be marked out of bounds at the 5-yard line. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And they were good last time out with a touchdown drive. This go around, it's not going to be very easy starting from inside their own 5.
But they shouldn't be daunted by it. You work on this the entire offseason. You work on it in practice. It's called coming out session. Start the ball inside the 5, start on the 5 on the 10. They should be ready to go.
Not great starting field position here for the offense. Back near his goal line, here's Breeze. And Breeze is going to go down in the end zone, a safety. Well, I think you can go ahead and give your punter an assist on that one. Pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by a great punt, and if the ball goes in the end zone, this never happens. So great call. Give the punt team and the punter some love.
Now the free kick comes after the safety from the 20 as they bring the punter on to try and get some hang time here. And this will be taken at the 13. Able to slither by. Tom Savage and the rest of his Texans offense heading back out there. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent, just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged, how big a mistake and when it occurs. No interceptions so far. They'll like that.
I just want you to know that you agreeing with me, that's going to get me through this third and fourth quarter. Are you touched? He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
Respect.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. To throw again. Savage got his man complete over the middle. It's Hopkins. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A big one there for the Texans, 18 yards.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. From the gun, Savage. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Second down following the incompletion. Play fake to Miller. Now Savage. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. He lost four there, and it's third down. The Texans on third down, 5 out of 9 thus far. This is third and 14.
Let's go.
They go play fake. Now Savage. And to the left side, Fedorowicz has it. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. Drew Brees getting ready to go again on offense. How do you think he personally is evaluating his game so far? He was pretty good in the first half, been good so far here in the third quarter. He's got to like it, right?
Not looking for the dramatics here. Not trying to set the world on fire in terms of stats. It's almost like you're driving. Hands at 10-2, alert for anything out there, watching for trouble on the road, and making sure you get the team home.
The bus driver. See if we can drive the bus here again on this drive. They try to fire up the run game with Adrian Peterson. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 5-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. Going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here live in New Orleans. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. Second down, 9 yards to go. They run again with Peterson. And he gets this one all the way up to the 24. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Grant, it's all about pace and tempo now for them. They've got the advantage, so I'm going to put musical terms for you. You don't want to go prestissimo. That's too quick, too lively, right? But you also don't want to slow it down too much. You don't want to go lento. What you really want to be is moderato. Nice and even, nice and steady. Get those gains and close out the game.
I think that chicken parm from last night's gone to your head. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Again, Peterson. And he'll get this one up to the 26. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
When a coaching staff sees their team run the ball this successfully in the fourth quarter, they're really excited because you can plan for a running game all you want to press that advantage when you get it. But for the most part, it's a little bit of a surprise. And right now, they've got to keep that going, want to continue to grind out the clock because it's definitely in their favor at this stage of the game. Can they close the game out and continue to do exactly what we just saw there? And that's run the football.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
On second down, Ingram. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Now Breeze on third down. It's complete to Flanner. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. Breeze finding Flanner for New Orleans first. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
So the offense has it first and 10. Peterson, and he'll get across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves and start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. Second down following the run. Another toad for the workhorse here this afternoon, Peterson. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
On third down, here's Kamara, and he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. Fresh set of downs here. They run, Peterson, and he'll be stopped up quickly here at the 38. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. Now they'll throw with Breeze. And the tight end has it. It's Flanner. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, that was an okay hookup there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
The Saints on third down. Can't be any better than a perfect 6-for-6. This will be third and 6. From the gun, it's Breeze. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. On fourth down, off goes Drew Breeze, and on comes the Saints kicker Will Lutz for the field goal attempt. It'll be spotted on the right hash, a 52-yard attempt. And this one is right down Broadway. And that will make the lead now 26. So it's 3 more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the 3 whenever you can.
Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And now out comes Houston. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
There's Savage on first down. Caught left side, Hopkins. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A fresh set of downs on a gain of 13 there for the Texans. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now the offense lining up first and 10. Savage from the shotgun snap. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. A pickup of 11 and a Texans first down.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Savage. Pushing through the contact. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10.
All right, here we go.
Throwing again. Savage. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he's brought down. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first. On first and 10, Savage. The hookup on the right side to Hopkins. And a nice gain of 21 yards. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Now inside the red zone, Savage. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Personal foul. Face mask.
So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it is going to be 15 yards.
Tight end right. Hurry up, here we go.
first down throw coming. Savage dumps it complete to Miller. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 3 yards is the gain that time. Second and goal. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they'll stop him with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. Say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. C.J. Fedorowicz, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage. Especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you just don't want to force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked off.
All right, here we go. B-19!
Play action. It's Savage. Is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out.
Illegal touching. Offense.
So take away the touchdown. It's kind of been one of those games for these guys.
I think it's safe to say that that type of a play just added to their misery, right?
And here, just playing for pride at this point. Down big, but they'll go for it on fourth and goal.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. Lamar Miller, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans get a bit closer. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, forget the field goal because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
And that'll make this a 19-point game. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And the result, a Houston touchdown. No back out now to kick this one away. This is taken at his 4. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Something unforeseen, this will be the last play of the game. Down to a knee here, the defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them.
And the Saints win in a game that wasn't even close. So unfortunately for the Texans, they're one and done. But please, if you can spare at least a dime, you should donate to J.J. Watt's Hurricane Harvey Relief Fund. And with that, we've got one game left in round one. And I'll see you guys there. Thanks for watching.